I've made a copy of the ODB06 Employees Form Database and renamed this to ODB07 Design Mode and opened it up. In the database window, we have got forms selected, and I'm going to open up our employees form by double-clicking on it. Before we move on, I just want to take a moment to point out something that I'm sure most of you already noticed, that our LibreOffice-based form is just a LibreOffice writer document with a few extra toolbars, like this one here along the left and at the bottom. But most of these toolbars are inactive. This one has a design mode on-off. Since it's inactive, it won't work here. I'm going to close this window and right-clicking on our employees form shows us we can copy, delete, rename, opens what we did when we double-clicked it. So we want to edit the form. And this edit mode is the same as design mode or design view. Now we see our toolbars are active. And to tell which toolbar this is, I'm going to put my arrow over those dots on the far left side, where on this one, it's the top. And then I can right click on it when I've got that four-sided arrow. Click on Custom Toolbar, and it tells me that this one is the Form Controls. I'm going to cancel out of here. And when I put my arrow over these icons, we see a tooltip appear. To make the tooltips appear or disappear if you don't want to see them, we'd go into Tools, Options. Under LibreOffice General, we've got this Tips checkbox. Check that if you want to see the tooltips, and uncheck it if you do not want to see the tooltips. So now we're in Edit Mode or Design View or Design Mode. They're all the same thing. I'll use them interchangeably because I've seen them listed in the documentation interchangeably. But if I come down to our design mode on off and we turn off design mode, we see the text box is filled with data from the table, or it appears as if it's in open view. So this is a quick way for us to see what our changes would look like with actual data in there. I'm going back into design mode, turning that on, and I want to make a change. I'm going to take the employee ID, I'm clicking and holding this down to move it, and moving it to this part of the form. Now I can use the mouse or I can use my arrows to move it up and down as well, or left and right. Now let's see how this would look with some data in it. I'm going back to the design mode on off and turning design mode off. And we notice that we lost our labels for everything above the field we changed. Let's go back into design mode. When we turn design mode off, we have the employee ID selected. If I unselect this by clicking off it, and now if we turn design mode off, we see all our labels. Turn it back on, I'm going to move my employee ID back using my undo button. And if I select something like end date, go out of design mode, we see the labels disappear. Don't have anything selected when we go out of design mode because it will affect our labels. So I mentioned that we have our labels on the left and our text box is on the right. But when I grab my text box to move my employee ID, it moved both the label and the text box. When I select it here, we see they're both selected. If I right-click on this selection, we can come down here to Group. We can either ungroup it or edit group. Let's edit group. When I'm in the edit group mode, I can select my text box or my label. If I select it and move it, to get out of group edit mode, I just click off the objects. Selecting the employee ID again shows that they're both grouped together again. So we went in, we changed one of the objects, but when we got out of the edit mode, they stayed grouped together. And the undo works with that as well. My other option is to ungroup them. Now I can move them independently, but even when I click off them and back on, they're still two independent objects. And I can undo those as well. And now they're grouped together again. Now I want to move this whole block of objects over to the right or down a little bit. In other LibreOffice modules, I would just need to select the top object to move, hold down Shift, and select the bottom object that I want to move, and it looks like they're all selected. When I move this to the right, we see it only moves the two that I actually selected and ignores all the ones in between. So Shift works like Control does in the other LibreOffice modules. If that's true, what happens when I hold down Control? If I hold down Control and select First Name Label, it selects only the label. It puts me into Group Edit mode. So holding down Control is a shortcut into Group Edit mode. I can select a couple of them at a time by holding down Control and Shift. And we see that on our left, we still have a lot of space here. So I'm going to remove some of that space by moving in the left line. I'm also going to move in the right side of our text boxes, since they stick out way further than we actually need. So I'm going to hold down Control, select last name text box. Then I'm also going to add Shift. So I've got Shift and Control held down, selecting the first name, gender, phone number, address, city, and state. I'm going to move this side in. Now I want to bring zip, department, and group down. So I'm going to click on the zip, hold down Shift, select department and group, and I'm going to move these down. And I want to make these boxes about half their size. So I'm going to hold down Control and click on the zip text box, add Shift, click on the department text box, and group text box. And now I'm just going to move in the line. To move all these three up a little bit, I need to select all of it, not just the text box. So I'm clicking off, clicking back on, holding down Shift, and clicking the other two. I'm just using my arrow keys to move that up a little. Now we have a lot of fields here. To select them all at one time, I don't want to have to sit there holding Shift and clicking every field. I want to lasso them in a selector. So I'm going to come down and click on our select arrow. Start. And I don't have it because I see my arrow looks like an I-beam. I need to click select again. And I've got the arrow. So I'm coming down and over, and everything with inside that selection area will be selected. And I can move this down with my arrow keys or my mouse, just like I did moving things around earlier. And there's one more thing I want to mention about grouping before we move on. We can also select multiple groups and right click and form a group with them. Group these together, and now these four will move as one solid group. I can undo that, undo again. Grouping was covered in detail in the LibreOffice Draw series. Now our form looks pretty good like this, but we need like a header or a title. To put that on, I'm going to come down here to our label field, and just like we did with our selection, I'm going to start in the upper left and go to the lower right. I could have started in the upper right. Just one corner to the opposite corner is what works. To change the label, I'm going to right click and bring up Control. And right here, the second one down, label, shows what is going to show up in the field itself. We're going to call this Employee Edit Form. When I click off that label, we see that our label here is updated. It's still a little difficult to see. To change that, we want to change the font. So coming down, we see something called the font. We've got the little dot, dot, dot box, which usually means I'm going to bring up a dialog box. And it does. I want to change the font. I'm going to make this Arial Black. We'll give it a size of 22. Looking at the font effects, we could change the color. We could make it a relief, overline, strike through. I'm going to make this an underline and give it a bold underline. That looks a little better. There are some other things on here you might want to play with, like the border and the background color. You can also change the alignment or the vertical alignment. We've got vertical alignment in the middle, the alignment's left. I'm going to change this one to center and close out of the properties. Now, we'll notice that if I try and move this, it's locked into that corner. I can move it up and down the left-hand side. But to move it over to the right more, I need to right-click on this and see how it's anchored. And this one appears to be anchored as a character. I want to anchor this to the page. If I anchor it to the page, I can then move it anywhere around the page that I like. We can see how this looks by going out of design mode. Then to save these changes, we want to click the Save button. I'm going to close my form. I also want to save the database. So I have two things I need to save. I need to save the form and the database. Now, if I double click to open this form, we see it's got our header, things are lined up the way we like, and all the other things we learned in the last video still work.